Are you thinking about selling your house, but you really just don't want to have to deal with the actual move? Well, this is a very common problem, and stick around because we're going to chit chat a little bit about some of the things that you can do to make life a little bit easier for you. So we'll be right back. With Berkshire Hathaway. So before I move forward, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell button. We send these videos out every Monday, and I will tell you that I'm loosening up a little bit. I'm very accustomed to kind of moving and talking at the same time. So I got myself a little bit more room here, a little bit bigger setup and whatnot. So, you know, maybe that comes across a little bit for you. Anyway, so as we move into our little chit chat today, I will say that this is a very common problem. People want to sell their house, but they don't want to move because it's a lot. There's a lot to do. I mean, even if you live in an apartment, you just accumulate things over the years. So here would be my first point of advice for you, is to definitely take the time to start to purge. And I know I've done videos on this before. Purge, purge, purge. It will free your life in ways you just never even thought. So that is definitely a huge issue with, but we accumulate a lot of stuff. We got garages full of stuff. We got sheds full of stuff, attics, drawers, closets, basements, you name it, second homes. So take the time to really decide what it is you don't want to take with you to the next house. Obviously, that's your first big issue. The instant your house goes under contract and you know your settlement date, I would set up your moving company. Make sure that you have the people that you need. Make sure you have a moving company. You have the size of the moving van that you need. The tentative yes from friends or neighbors or family that will be helping you on that day. Whatever it is, make sure you carve that time out, because you, the last thing you want to do is to get 1 week before moving date and then decide to call a moving company because you may not get one, and then you're going to really be stuck. You can also consider, if you don't have a second home to already go to, you can consider getting a pod, or they have the, you know, the storage units that you can sit in the driveway for however long. And, you know, people understand. They know you're moving. So if they see a pod in the driveway, it's not the end of the world. So that would be the second item. Then I would definitely begin the process of lining up your change of address cards. Obviously, you may not have another address to go to just yet. And I have some cheat sheets that I can share with you as well at the end of this video. So make sure you stick around for those, and they are definitely a big help. Just reminders and little tidbits of information. If you are in the market for a new home, another item you want to be very aware of is whether or not you're paying cash for your next home, or whether or not you need the funds from this particular sale in order to purchase the next home. In the event that that is the case, and you, maybe you still need a mortgage, or you're taking some of these funds to put down on the next house, however that'll work, your realtor should definitely work with you to make sure that you have a secure loan for the next move. Now, selling your house is more important than landing the next one initially, because many sellers are not taking a home sale contingency. So just be very aware of that. So that means we want to make sure your house is perfect and ready to go, so it sells right away. So you have that on your agreement of sale when you're ready to buy the next house. Another item to consider is whether or not you have items in your home to sell. So if you have, I don't know, maybe you have some antiques you are willing to sell, or you want to sell, you've been looking to get rid of them. Maybe you have an old car, there's things in the basement, maybe you, it's time to have a huge yard sale, and take those funds, and I mean, you do whatever you want with them, but maybe those funds are going to be used to put down towards the next home. Of course, I could go on and on and on. I hope this information was helpful for you, and I'll see you at the next video.